Hello everyone, this video is basically part 2 of post-insertion problems in complete denture. So if you have watched my previous two videos, that is the one on pressure indicating paste and part 1 of post-insertion problems in CD, then by now you should be well equipped with sufficient knowledge not only to identify the denture related problem and establish the most probable cause of that problem, but also to identify the pressure spots in the denture by using a pressure indicating paste in a correct manner. However, in case you missed out the previous two videos, I'll link them down below in the description box for you, so that you should first be able to identify and understand the denture problem before proceeding further to correct it. So if you want to know how to deal with the discomfort and soreness related to different surfaces of denture, then continue watching this video. In this video, I'll tell you how to deal with the pain or discomfort or soreness associated with the complete denture. And before this, I would first like to tell you about the three surfaces of the denture which I'll be discussing further. So first is the impression surface or the fitting surface of the denture, also known as the intaglio surface, that is the surface of the denture which comes in contact with the oral tissues. And second is the polished surface, also known as the cameo surface. And third is the occlusal surface, which obviously means the occlusal surfaces of the teeth of the denture. So you can see in this picture that this is the impression surface or the fitting surface of the denture, also called as the intaglio surface. And this one is the polished surface, also called as the cameo surface of the denture. So starting with the discomfort related to the impression surface of the denture. So first is, in case if the patient presents with discrete painful areas, it may be most probably because of the pearls or nodules of acrylic, you know, on the fitting surfaces of the denture, which occur due to the inadequate finishing of the denture by the lab. And what we can do in this case is locate these with the finger or a dry cotton wool and then eliminate or remove the irregularities or the nodules. And the second thing is, if the patient comes with the pain on insertion or removal of the complete denture, then most probably mucosal inflammation would be present, and such inflammation can be seen on the sides of the ridges in the patient's mouth. And this occurs mostly when the denture is not adequately relieved in the areas of undercuts. So in this case, use a pressure indicating paste to identify the problematic area of denture and relieve it accordingly. Make sure that you don't over reduce, otherwise it would result in a decrease in retention of denture and hence lose dentures, which we don't want, right? So if you want to know what is the proper method to use a pressure indicating paste or PIP, then do check out my previous video where I have explained it in detail. And sometimes complete denture patients report with certain areas in mouth which are painful to pressure. And such pressure areas may be due to various reasons, like faulty impressions or damage to working cast or even warpage of the denture base, or sometimes residual pathology may be present, for example retained root, or in some cases if inadequate relief is given to active frena, or in cases where there are inadequately relieved bony prominences, for example torus. So in such cases, we use a pressure indicating paste to locate the area which is to be relieved. But in case if the discrepancy is severe, it is advisable to remake the denture. And in case if a pathology like a retained root piece is present, then removal of root piece is considered. Next, I'll tell you about the discomfort related to polished surface of the denture. And in this case, patient generally complains of pain at posterior aspect of upper denture, which occurs during opening of mouth. and such pain may be due to a too thick flange, which is present on the buccal aspect of tuberosity, which further constrains the cornoid process during opening mouth. And in this case, it is generally advised to accurately define this area using a disc closing material and then relieve it and repolish it. Next, I'll tell you about the discomfort related to occlusal surface of denture. So in case a patient complains of pain on eating in presence of occlusal imbalance, and this occurs most probably because of the presence of anterior or posterior prematurity. And to treat this, we need to determine the occlusal prematurities and adjust the occlusion by selective grinding. Another most common complaint of patient related to occlusal surfaces of the denture is lip biting or cheek biting. And firstly, I'll tell you the reason for lip biting. It is due to the absence of lip support. That is, the denture-based material does not provide enough support, or there may be excessive anterior horizontal overlap. That means excessive overjet. So in case if there is absence of lip support, we need to extend the short periphery of the denture. And in case if there is excessive overjet, it can be corrected by grinding the lower incisors in order to provide more incisal guide angle. That is to increase the anterior guidance. And for those who want to know what is the difference between overbite and overjet, I'll tell you with the help of this diagram that the vertical overlap between the incisal edges is the overbite and the horizontal overlap is the overjet, as we can see in this diagram. As I've already explained that when excessive overjet is the cause of lip biting, we need to increase the anterior guidance. And cheek biting generally happens if the width of sulcus is not restored. So what we do in this case is a restoration of functional sulcus width is advised in such case. And this can be done by recontouring the buccal surfaces of the mandibular molars. Another most common complaint of patient related to occlusal surfaces of denture is tongue biting, and it usually occurs because of the combination of posterior teeth being placed in lingual position together with the sharpness of cusps, and this can be treated by reduction and smoothing of teeth on the lingual aspect. So that's it for today's video. I hope you found it helpful. I'll see you soon in my next video, in which I'll tell you how to deal with the two most common complaints of complete denture patients, that is difficulty in swallowing and gagging problems. So stay tuned for the next video. So yeah, if you like this video, do hit that like button and share this video with your friends and spread the knowledge. Make sure that you are subscribed to this channel, Dentistified, if you haven't already, and hit that bell icon which is next to the subscribe button so that you get notified each time I upload a new video. So that's it for today. See you in my next one.